Praise the Lord, everyone. So today, as I was just spending time with the Lord, I was led to read Psalm 71. It's a beautiful psalm. So I want to read that to you. If you have Bible, you can open to Psalm 71. It says, "In you, O Lord, I have taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Rescue me and deliver me in your righteousness. Turn your ear to me and save me. Be my rock of refuge to which I can always go. Give the command to save me, for you are my rock and my fortress. Deliver me, O my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the grasp of evil and cruel men. For you've been my hope, O Sovereign Lord, my confidence since my youth. From birth I have relied on you. You brought me forth from my mother's womb. I'll ever praise you. I have become like a portent to many, but you are my strong refuge. My mouth is filled with your praise, declaring your splendor all day long. Do not cast me away when I'm old. Do not forsake me when my strength is gone. For my enemies speak against me. Those who wait to kill me conspire together. They say, 'God has forsaken him. Pursue him and seize him, for no one will rescue him.' Be not far from me, O God. Come quickly, O my God, to help me. May my accusers perish in shame. May those who want to harm me be covered with scorn and disgrace. But as for me, I'll always have hope. I will praise you more and more. My mouth will tell of your righteousness, of your salvation all day long. Though I know not its measure, I will come and proclaim your mighty acts, O Sovereign Lord. I'll proclaim your righteousness, yours alone. Since my youth, O God, you have taught me, and to this day I declare your marvelous deeds. Even when I am old and gray, do not forsake me, O God, till I declare your power to the next generation, your might to all who are to come. Your righteousness reaches to the skies, O God. You who have done great things, who, O God, is like you? Though you have made me see troubles many and bitter, you will rescue my life again. From the depths of the earth, you will again bring me up. You will increase my honor and comfort me once again. I'll praise you with the harp for your faithfulness, O my God. I'll sing praise to you with the lyre, O Holy One of Israel. My lips will shout for joy when I sing praise to you, I whom you have redeemed. My tongue will tell of your righteous acts all day long, for those who wanted to harm me have been put to shame and confusion." Amen. It's a beautiful psalm, and I really feel like reading it like 10 to 20, 21 times today, you know. Sometimes Holy Spirit leads us to do things which doesn't make any sense. You know, you may feel like, why 21 times? Even I do not know. But sometimes when Lord asks us to do something, it's always better to obey. You know, sometimes those are like the life jackets that we get while we are drowning. So I think Psalm 71 for me today is like a life jacket. If you are led by the Holy Spirit to read Psalm 71 as much as possible, as many times as possible, do it. It's like the oxygen cylinder, like the ventilator the patient is connected in the ICU. It's like a lifesaver for me today. I don't know what's in store for me this day, but I know that if I do this, I'll be safe. Sometimes I encourage you that as you walk with the Lord, as you grow in the Lord, or even as you are beginning to understand the ways of God, just obey what He's asking you to do, even if it doesn't make sense. You know, God loves you. He wants the best for you. He cares for you. He's concerned about you. And Bible says, whatever concerns you, He will make it perfect. Surrender and submit to God. Speak every problem to the Lord. Tell Him this is what you're going through. This is what you need. And this is what you understand about the situation. He will bring clarity in your situation. He will clear your mind, clear your thought. Spend time with the Lord. I encourage you to read Psalm 71 today as a rescue. You know, it's funny how God moves, but He moves the best way. Like a pilot, we just have to just trust in Him. He's the one who is taking the flight, who's leading us. He's in the captain's seat. It's always better to listen to Him and to just follow His unction. So I bless you. Let me just pray for you. Holy God, thank you for this time, Lord. Bless everyone who is listening to this prayer. And as even as we are reading Psalm 71, Father, I pray that you will speak to us through the psalm, and you will speak to us, give us more clarity in situations that we are going through, give us answer to solutions, Father, that we are asking for. Father God, we pray that those who are looking for an opening in the job, Father God, I pray that you will give them an opportunity, Father God, doors of blessing to be opened in their life in the name of Jesus. Those who are looking for a closure in relationship, I pray that you will give that. Those who are looking for a confirmation in a relationship or in a job or in a decision, Father God, I pray that you will send your word and confirm it, Father God, for them, Lord. Lord, give clarity, Lord Jesus. I pray for your clarity in life of people, Father. Your children, Lord Jesus. Where you are, there is no confusion, Father God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for this beautiful day, Father. We surrender ourselves completely, our body, soul, spirit, into your hands, Father God. We belong to you. We acknowledge our complete dependency on you, Father. Lord, we give you glory, Father, in Jesus' most precious name. Father, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. I bless you and I encourage you to pray every day, to read the Word of God, to spend time with God. You know, there is a prayer that I pray every day. It is, bless me and make me a blessing for millions. I listened this 15 years ago from Joyce Meyer, and I really did this every day, and I know that God honors our simple prayers, you know. So pray it like, God, bless me and make me a blessing for thousands and millions, for others. Make me a channel of your glory, of your blessing. Secondly, I pray for five things. I pray, Father, give me, Father, discernment, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and fear of God. Fear of God is so important. Fear of God is not being afraid, but being reverent, in love with the Lord, in love and admiration for who He is, understanding His magnificent, His sovereignty. You rever Him, you love Him, and you fear Him. The more you grow closer to the Lord, like the more you mature in the Lord, like once the baby doesn't really get scared because baby is in his own world and the parents love him. And as the baby grows up, the father disciplines. As he becomes an adult and, you know, suppose he is working, partnering with in his father's business, his father is different. Though his father love him, there is another side of the father that he prunes the son to be a leader in the business. That's what happens when we grow in the Lord. The more we grow in the sonship of God, more we take Him seriously. So I bless you as you grow in the Lord. I pray that you will understand the depth of His love for you, unconditional love for you, and the potential, the unlimited potential that He has placed in you. So God bless you. I'll come tomorrow, if God willing, with a new word from the Lord. I bless you. Praise God. Have a good day.